Next is cyber crime. The internet is an amazing tool for communication, allowing users to connect instantly over great distances. Unfortunately, the same communication is also a great tool for criminals. A crime in which computer network or devices are used is called a cyber crime. For example, identity theft. One common form of cyber crime is identity theft. Hackers may use fake emails to trap someone to give passwords and account information. Transaction fraud. Some financial fraud is another common crime in the online arena. A scammer may offer an item for sale through an auction site with no intention of delivering once he or she receives payment. Alternatively, a criminal might purchase an item for sale using a stolen credit card. It is also possible to buy something from own credit card but then reporting the card stolen. This is a transaction fraud if the cardholder claims charge back. Advance fee fraud. Sometimes the hackers congratulate you upon winning a big prize and ask you pay a small amount in advance so that the prize can be dispatched. This is a common type of cybercrime. The lure of easy wealth has found many victims of these frauds. Hacking. Another cybercrime is the practice of hacking. Illegally accessing someone else's computer. This happens mostly when you download some file from internet and execute it without knowing details. A software installed in your computer connects someone else to your computer without your permission. The aim is to gather information about a person or organization, sometimes without their knowledge. This type of software is called spyware. Next is piracy. Piracy is also a type of cybercrime. Details about piracy already discussed in the previous section. The next topic is characteristics of a phishing attack. Phishing is the fraudulent attempt by sending emails to obtain sensitive information such as usernames, password, and credit card details. Characteristics of phishing emails. First one is it normally appears as an important notice, urgent update, or alert. The subject of such email is set in a way that the email recipient believes that the email has come from a trusted source. For example, someone tried to open your account, change your password immediately. Official data breach notification, packet delivery at your home address, IT reminder, your password expires in less than 24 hours. Change of password required immediately. Revised vacation and sick time policy. Email account updates. The second characteristic is it sometimes contains messages that sound attractive rather than threatening, like promising the recipients a prize or a reward. Third one is it normally uses forged senders. Address, for example, admins@facebook.com or info@gmail.com, etc. You can also open an email if it is from principal.yourschool.education.pk. In email, there can be some links that has no relation with your school. So while filling online forms, take care of the URL appearing in the address bar of the web browser. It usually takes contents such as logos, images from the actual website to make the fraudulent email look like a genuine email. Next is, it may contain a form for the recipient to fill in personal financial information and let recipient submit it. This information is submitted to a different database. Characteristics of a phishing website. First one is, it looks like original due to the same contents such as images, text, logos, colors, scheme, etc. Second one is, it may contain actual links to web contents of the legitimate website such as contact us, privacy, or disclaimer to trick the visitors. It may use similar name as that of the actual website. It may use forms to collect visitors' information where these forms are similar to those in the legitimate information. Next is DOS, denial of service attack. In computing, a denial of service attack is a cyber attack to make a machine or network resource unavailable. It means a service is denied. For example, if you want to visit a website but someone else is already sending too many requests to the same website using computer program, then you may not be able to access that website. This type of attack is shown. It is just like a robot is sending many requests in small amount of times. But for a user, either the service becomes very slow or it is denied. So by flooding the targeted machine or resource with the superfluous request is an attempt to overload the system. It may also cause shutting down a machine or network. DOS attackers often target web servers of high-profile organizations such as banking, commerce, and media companies or government and trade organizations. Though DOS attacks do not typically result in the theft or loss of significant information or other assets, they can cost the victim a great deal of time and money. Next is exercise. Choose the correct option. First one is, which of the following does not include the type of software privacy? Softlifting, liability, client-server overuse, or online piracy? The correct option is liability, second one. Which of the following is not a cybercrime? Hacking, phishing crime, identity theft, decryption. The correct option is decryption. Fourth option. Which of the following is not the characteristics of phishing emails? First is official data breach notification, email account update, IT reminder, similar domain of actual website. Correct option is similar domain of actual website. Fourth one. Which of the following is not characteristics of phishing website? Similar domain of actual website, using of forms to collect visitors, actual link to web content, email account update. The correct option is email account updates. Which of the following is not a characteristics of good password? Is 8 characteristic long? Doesn't contain username, contains uppercase letters, password is your name only. The correct option is password is your name only. Next is fill in the blanks. Making illegal copies of software is called dash. It is called piracy. Second one is, dash is a general term for any type of information processing that can be represented mathematically. It is computation. Third is, dash is the process of encoding data. Encryption. Encryption is the process of encoding data. Fourth one is, when a key has less number of characters than the text to encrypt, then repeating letters of the key is called dash. It is called interim ciphertext. Fifth one is dash is a cyber attack to make a machine or network resource unavailable for a user. It is DOS, denial of service attack. This was our today's lecture. I hope you understand. Thank you.